Things got a little rowdy, didn't they, in the halls of Parliament House yesterday. Labor frontbencher Tanya Plibersek going head-to-head with controversial MP Craig Kelly over his spreading of COVID-19 information.
My mum lives in your electorate and I don't want her exposed to people who are not going to be vaccinated because of these crazy conspiracy theories that you're spreading.
Well, you're the one doing that because you are the one spreading misinformation. Right? You've got to listen to the professors, listen to our most senior immunologists.
And so your Prime Minister is wrong, is he?
Our Prime Minister is 100% right.
Well, let's bring in Shadow Minister for Education and Training, Tanya Plibersek, in Canberra. Tanya, Craig, I mean, he came up right behind you as you called him a taxpayer-funded nong. Looking at that exchange, I think your face said it all.
Look, this is really just too important to allow this sort of misinformation to spread in our community. The government spending $24 million on an advertising campaign to urge people to get vaccinated, and you've got this bloke out there saying the opposite. I think it just had to stop. Like I said yesterday, my mum lives in his electorate. I don't want her going to the shops and being exposed to people who've refused to be vaccinated because their local MP has told them to think twice about it. Leaders should be speaking with one voice. I agree with the Prime Minister, with the Health Minister, with the Chief Medical Officer, saying that people should get vaccinated as soon as it's safe to do so, so that we can get life back to normal, so we can reopen our businesses, reopen our borders, and most importantly, keep people safe.
Do you think the Prime Minister's got a problem with the far right of the party?
Yeah, I do. I think he allows people like Craig Kelly, George Christensen and others to... It's the tail wagging the dog. Mm. The Liberal Party is really under the thumb of... I think it is a small group, but a small group of people who identify with a sort of Donald Trump view of the world, and that's not healthy for our Australian democracy.
I mean, I did note yesterday too that there are coalition members who've come out in support of Craig Kelly, that he should have the right to say whatever he wants to say. The fact that he has finally received this dressing down from the Prime Minister, is it too little too late? Has too much damage been done?
I think two things. I 100% support free speech. What I don't support is taxpayer-funded disinformation. Like the wrong facts, the exact opposite of the truth being spread. Effectively, you know, Craig Kelly's on the taxpayer dollar. That's it, pays his wages, it pays his communications budget. And that that is reaching a lot of people. And if it comes from their local MP, maybe they think it's true. So he's, of course, allowed his own opinions, but he's not allowed his own set of facts. And I think, you know, I'm very pleased that the Prime Minister did finally call him into line yesterday after earlier in the week saying he's doing a good job, because this is too important. The health of Australians and the reconstruction of our economy depends on Craig Kelly pulling his head in on this. You know, he's got a right to his own opinions, but he can't spread these crazy conspiracies about COVID-19 treatments and vaccines.
Tanya, whether it's by design or not, I get the feeling you believe it's your time. Is it?
Well, it was my turn to tell Craig Kelly to pull his head in yesterday. I think that's all you can draw from what happened yesterday.
But you're
on a roll, right? You're on a roll and you're making headway. You believe it's your time. Will you have the courage to take Arbo on?
Oh, this is, you know, people want to see everything in an internal Labor Party frame. I'm just not going to do that. What matters now is the health of our people and the strength of our economy. My 100% focus, Labor's 100% focus, is on making sure that we recover from this pandemic by getting our community vaccinated and by making sure that there are secure jobs with decent pay as we come out of this recession. Mm. We don't want the effects of this recession to hurt particularly our young people for generations, which is what normally happens after a recession. You see years of struggle and poverty afterwards. We need to get the economy back on its feet with good jobs, decent jobs, secure pay, so that people feel confident that they can, you know, take the kids out on a Saturday night to the movies and a pizza. That sort of confidence creates jobs for other people.
Yeah, and that Tanya, is all good, and it's a nice diversion from what Carl was asking, but when you've got Labor power brokers meeting up for secret dinners to talk about the fact they're not happy with how Anthony Albanese is going, there are things happening behind the scenes.
Well, I wasn't invited to any dinner like that, so, I don't think it's any, you know, remarkable thing that people who are away from home in Canberra together go out for dinner. I don't think people ought to read too much into the tea leaves on that
one. Won't be the first or the last time plotting happens over a lazy Susan.
Well,
right?
it won't be the first or last time people have dinner together in Canberra. Like, it's not that remarkable.
And it won't be the last time you're asked about that. Tanya, always appreciate you coming on. Thank you for your time
Tanya.
Today. Appreciate it.
It's a pleasure.